What's going on, guys? We are heading down to the shop, Frankie's Free Range Meat. It is Tuesday. You know what game we play in the Bronx, boys? It's called Musical Cars. Because if you thought there were traffic laws, just drive over here. I have no clue what people are doing. They're going this way, they're going that way, they're turning, I don't know. There's the red lights don't matter, green lights don't matter, pedestrians don't matter. I mean, you know, it does keep you open-minded and dynamic every day, open to change. So it's a good thing, I guess.
So there's a Verizon truck here. I don't really know what they're doing because I can't tell what type of equipment is in this over here. But I think I'll go up to these guys and ask them if they're installing stuff.
Hey, what's going on, man? Is the power out or something on the street? Is the Wi-Fi out? I didn't see that coming. What are they having you guys do over here? Is that power or is that electric? No power?
I'm not gonna bother these guys because I know what they're doing, but I mean, the guy said he's not doing any power at all. So if he's not doing power, what's so important that everyone's locked inside and these guys are working on these lamps and these towers outside? They're installing new Wi-Fi infrastructure. It's ridiculous. You know, this doesn't have to be proven over and over again. You know, we know exactly what they're doing. We just have to convince people that it's not safe. So I just got down to Frankie's Free Range Meat a bit later than I normally do. It's about 11:30. And as I've told you guys, you know, we're at the point where my business partner, Adam, and our employee, Mike, are able to get most of the orders done. Unless we have a really high order volume, then I come down because I'm handling, you know, all the online stuff, all the emails, website maintenance, advertising, stuff like that. So, you know, these guys are doing the bulk of, you know, the physical day-to-day stuff. I'll come down once or twice a week. And then hopefully in the near future, we'll have things up and running fully without having to work ourselves to death physically. So we're still stuck in this facility, you know, with the Toyota Corolla nonsense and all the craziness. Like we don't know if we're ever gonna get out of here. It's middle of April right now. We were supposed to be out of here in February, but we're definitely gonna be out of here in like 2 or 3 months. We're gonna have a new building, new equipment. Hopefully that will allow us to do, you know, higher volumes of pemmican, higher volumes of jerky, just expand our inventory in a way that, you know, we can sustain a higher order volume. So far, Adam and Mike have done about, what did you guys do, 30, 40 orders today? So far?
Oh, so far, yeah.
And we have like 100 to do? Yeah, we have 100. Yeah, we've been doing about 100 orders a day. And, you know, some weeks we'll have like 150, some weeks we'll have like 250. So when we're a little bit busier, I'll come down and help out. But it's not like super, super crazy difficult like it was when we started. And when we do get in that new facility, it's going to be, you know, so much easier, so much more streamlined. And, you know, we're going to save a lot of money on stuff like packaging materials and things that we're buying at a higher volume in bulk. And, you know, really looking forward to seeing where things go. It's almost been a year now. I think another 2 or 3 months and we'll be, you know, actually physically up and running for a year. But we launched like the idea on YouTube last year around this time. So, you know, things are panning out, obviously not as quickly as anyone anticipates, but I'm looking forward to it. Thankfully, me and Adam don't have to interact with anyone else. So, you know, he drives from his house here. I drive from my house here. You know, no one else is working in our facility besides us. There's no interaction. So, you know, our business is largely unaffected by what's going on right now. You know, just in regards to like an interaction standpoint, if there was any truth to this Toyota Corolla nonsense. So, you know, like a lot of other businesses are closing, they're getting screwed over. You know, there were some protests in Ohio yesterday. If you guys didn't see that, you know, it's really sad. People that have had small businesses for 25, 26, 27 years are going bankrupt out of business, you know, all for what? You know, for what? And the government hasn't really stepped in to help us yet with any loans or anything. So, you know, we're in a pretty good spot. You know, our inventory is reduced. We're not getting as many products in as we were, but we're still, you know, full steam ahead and things are going well for now. We're definitely looking to put ourselves in a better position in the future if something like this does happen again, so that we can provide you guys with high quality animal foods. But I'm going to start filling some orders for a couple hours and then we'll go over some of the new products that we have. So normally I'm running back and forth between the freezers and getting the stuff for the orders. Today I'm actually just gonna put the items in the boxes. And you know, the former is, you know, a little busier and you have to know where everything is. And since I'm not in here every day now, you know, it's easier for Adam to just, you know, pull the orders. And I'm gonna do this for the first time. So Frankie boy gets the easy way out now, I guess, right? That means I'm wearing three shirts for nothing. I always wear like two t-shirts, my long johns, you know, another shirt and a jacket, literally like 3, 4, 5 layers, because you know, I'm in the freezer all day and it gets really, really cold in there, 0 degrees. Even though we mostly sell meat, you know, a lot of you guys like buying our organs, butter and cheese. So, you know, this order is pretty much, you know, butter, cheese, brains, you know. So one thing we do enjoy doing is getting stuff that you guys don't have access to from other purveyors. And, you know, moving forward in the future, that's really going to be what we're doing. We're going to literally have every single organ of an animal available for you guys to buy, the glands, the stomach, hopefully even the blood and all that type of stuff. You know, we've been meeting all of our expectations. And as I said, you know, things are going slower, but we're still gonna get everything we wanna do eventually. This includes the raw dairy, the grain-free eggs, you know, the glandulars, the brains, the blood, all of that stuff that you guys have been asking for. You know, I've been pushing to think about how we can get this stuff in, and, you know, hopefully, you know, sometime next year, maybe towards the end of this year, we have a real plan in place. You know, but as you guys know, a lot of these farms that have been doing this stuff, that sell this stuff, have been doing it, you know, for years and years and years and years. And, you know, to break into this so quickly from scratch without any investment, it's a whole different ballgame. I am looking into applying for some loans here and there to see if we can get the money to start up. And, you know, if that's the case, I'll definitely keep you guys posted, and exciting stuff. This is the 5-pound organic ground beef that we're offering right now. I believe it's like $8.50, $9 a pound. So if you guys are looking to get, you know, bulk organic ground beef, or, you know, have a little fun with a large tube of meat, we got it. Mike, how long have you been with us now? It's been like 3 months, right?
Since the middle of November, I think, end of November, right before Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
You said they were gonna lock us inside until the end of April. Then they're gonna say like, oh, we need until the middle of May. Then in the middle of May, they're gonna say, oh, we need till the end of May. And that thing's gonna be back by June.
So I've heard, might not have a summer this year.
Yeah, who knows what these wackos are doing, whether that Q stuff, where they're arresting people, is true, or whether it's related to the food supply. I mean, it's hard to say, but I think it's, you know, completely ridiculous what's going on. And the only thing I'm really worried about is, again, how easily, you know, people listen to authority, and that results in, you know, them being able to do this again incredibly easily, you know, in the fall, in the winter. Who's to say they don't make this a yearly thing?
As some of you guys know, we've been out of pemmican for the past week or two due to the high demand. And these are actually some new shapes we're trying. Some of you guys were used to the old Reese's Cups pemmican that we have over here. You know, they come like this. So this is like 8 ounces of pemmican, pretty much all the calories you need for the day. And instead of these packets, we're gonna do something like a bar that's gonna be like this. So it's basically gonna be all the calories you need for the day, and it's gonna be easy to pack, easy to transport, you know, one solid bar.
And as with all of our products, let me know what you guys think. You know, if you like something in particular, you know, if we got rid of something that you liked. And I'd really love to know what you guys think of our First Light Wagyu products. You know, it is grass-fed Wagyu. It's not traditional. And, you know, we have a fairly small customer base right now. So, you know, we're not really too enthusiastic about selling super high-end luxury products. I mean, yeah, we could start selling sturgeon caviar, beluga caviar for, you know, 200, 300 an ounce on our website. But, you know, we know our customer base, you know, doesn't really want that stuff right now. But you know, when you do have that larger customer pool to choose from, you know, you could put on exotic luxury stuff that people will have on a birthday or an anniversary. But at this point in time right now, as we're still growing, you know, we're trying to, you know, feel things out and see what we want to do.
So it's 2:45 right now. I got in at 11:30. So I think we've been filling orders for, you know, about 3 hours straight. Not too much work today, and we're all wrapped up. So we did know, 100 orders today.
Another new thing is that we're shipping FedEx instead of UPS. We got slightly better rates, and FedEx does deliver on Saturday and Sunday, whereas UPS won't deliver on Sunday. So, you know, we should have less issues with, you know, packages being held over the weekend. And that maybe happened to like 1 in 100 orders, you know, but we really want all of our customers to have, you know, the experience that they're supposed to. So me and Adam have been talking about the farm property that we're going to get upstate. So hopefully, you know, 2-3 years from now, things are going to be, you know, fully what we want them to be. And maybe like a year and a half from now, you guys are going to start seeing some very unique things that no one else is doing or willing to do. So maybe we'll see if Adam has something to say. Otherwise, I think we're going to be done for today.
So this is the blueberry pemmican. He's eating it like a giant chocolate bar.
Whoa.
That looks good.
Texture's good.
That looks really good.
One bar, all your daily calories.
This is crazy. This
80%
is great.
Fat, 10% carb, 10% protein.
And we haven't even done like the secret ideas that you had a year ago. We haven't even done all this non-perishable stuff yet.
A lot of stuff going on.
Hopefully we get the dehydrator in that new facility, right?
That'd be amazing if we could get a really large dehydrator and start producing this stuff on a larger scale. This is the blueberry too, which obviously has carbs, but the regular doesn't have any carbohydrates. So.
Yeah, blueberry, honey, all high quality ingredients. And when you're, you know, doing something hiking or, you know, you need a lot of caloric energy, you know, there's nothing wrong with having carbs and fats in it. If anything, people usually feel better with the carbs. Mm-hmm. And it makes it a lot more enjoyable too. Mm-hmm. The plain pemmican is more like if you're really hungry and like starving, you kind of want to eat it. That's like you could eat it as a snack.
Wow. These blueberries are low temperature dried, so they still have...
It's like a chew to it, right?
Yeah, and they have like their natural acidity and a lot of their flavor. You can really taste them.
People have been emailing me about the cookies.
I'm working on it. We had a quote right before this whole thing blew up.
You were going to have someone make the cookies.
Mm-hmm. Shut down.
Everyone shut down. Guys, take a look at this. This is our Wagyu short rib. This is what, probably 12, 14 pounds?
12 pounds.
This is the 12-pound Wagyu short rib. If you guys have never had short ribs in general, they're like a great fatty cut, but this is a whole different story. The Wagyu is way more tender. We're gonna cook this up on Saturday. And this is packaged really nicely. You know, you could probably literally eat for a week on just one of these things.
Those are the Wagyu strips, high marbling.
Yep.
Best steaks I've had. I usually like ribeye, but the strip is really, really good too.
Wagyu strip is
good. What's back in stock?
30 beef hearts came in, 150 orders of beef suet, and 150 orders of 2-pound
Okay. And we got the Finlandia back in stock. All the cheeses are good to go.
We have 1,000 pounds of butter. So Finlandia is good to go.
So I was at my local farmer's market last weekend, and they had this 6-year reserve sheep. What is it? A sheep cheddar? Mm-hmm. Is that what they said it is? Yeah, sheep cheddar. Looks ancient. You guys can tell how old this is.
They haven't let it get too dry. It's good.
It's like $30 a pound. I'm surprised it wasn't more. A 6-year cheese. Is it even good?
This has been well digested by microbial colonies. The texture is incredibly soft. For an old cheese, I would have thought it would be very hard. It just melts in your mouth. But it tastes like licking a sheep's balls, basically.
It's like a barnyard. It's nothing special, right? It's like 6 years, probably too long.
It's everything is really flat. It tastes heavily microbially digested.
Yeah.
It's good.
Dank. Is that a good word for it?
But enjoyable. Oop, I'm going in.
You know, there's a reason the indigenous people fermented these cheeses for like a year, you know. Past a year, you already maximized the microbial content. It's not really going to get any better.
Mm-hmm. That's going to be it for today, boys. Thank you guys for joining me. You know, of course, let me know if you guys would like to see anything else, any questions about the products, you know, anything additionally about what we're going to do in the future. You know, I keep saying, like, I really want to take things day by day. And although I do keep, you know, the future options on the back burner, you know, reality is, you have to be patient about this stuff.
Quick little tour for you guys. We just got, you know, some packaging material here.
Okay. I'll get a bigger size.
Some crates, more boxes, cod liver. Here's our packages. Got our packages here, packages. There's some ovens here, and then there's some ovens in the other kitchen that we use for rendering the beef. And sometimes we do the tallow in there as well. Some more ovens over here. This is the other freezer. This is where we keep like a little bit of everything. Whereas that big freezer over there is like back stock and more stuff. You know, just packaging materials on top of packaging materials. And there's even, you know, more stuff here and even, you know, more stuff in there. That's actually all cod liver. That's pretty funny.
It's kind of a blessing and a curse that we don't have a large space and large inventory because, you know, we literally turn everything over every single week. Everything you guys see in here, you know, this week, you know, we sell it all and we start fresh next week. So, you know, it gives us a bit of freedom and, you know, less worry about having, you know, thousands and thousands of pounds worth of product on hand. If you guys haven't signed up for our newsletter on Frankie's Free Range Meat, you know, definitely go to the website, sign up. You know, even if we don't have something that you'd like now, you know, we're sending out emails, you know, on a bi-weekly, weekly basis with new products, back in stock stuff. You know, I didn't really talk about or show you guys, you know, we have the Iberico pork from Spain, highest quality pork you will ever have. And I think it's really undervalued because you really can't get soy-free and corn-free pork in the United States. We have the salmon caviar, the fish roe, very approachable source of omega-3s, DHA. You know, we have the lamb brains at a pretty affordable price. You know, no one else is selling that stuff. And of course, the raw cheese. You know, I mean, to me, cheese is one of the most delicious, approachable, and nutritious foods. So definitely check all that stuff out, guys. Definitely tune in on Saturday. We're going to do a Korean-style short rib recipe. But thanks again for joining me, guys. And I'll see you soon.